Hello everyone, I welcome to our English class, Basic English Subject, Chapter 5, Making Requests, Unit 1, Speaking. Today you are going to learn making requests. What do you understand by the title, making requests? Making means using the word, correct proper sentence. Proper phrase. Asking. Request. Request means maybe it's a help. How to get help from others? How to take help from others? Generally, people are ready to help. People are ready to offer help. But that depends on the way we request, the way we ask. If you ask politely, definitely they will help you, definitely they will offer you. But the thing is, we have to ask them politely. Polite manner is very important. Our tone, our voice must be in a pleasing manner. That must be in a requesting manner, not in a demanding manner. If your voice is in a demanding manner, definitely you will not get help. That is final. So your voice, your sentences must be synced. But you, that means you are saying, will you please help? Will you please help me? This is a requesting sentence. Will you please help me? Maybe the sentence is correct, but your tone is wrong. The tone doesn't suit here. So tone is very important as well as sentence, the expression is important. So in this chapter, you have two parts. One is taking help, other one is offering help. Taking help means you are in need. Basically, from the morning to evening, we do so many things. In that things, generally, sometimes we do ourselves single. Solely we do. Sometimes we do something in a group. So everything we may not do, everything we may not complete the task. So sometimes we have to take help. So how to take help is important. Now come to the lesson. See. When you ask someone to do something for you, or if you can do something, it is important to sound polite. Here, if you need help, you must be polite while requesting. And the second one is, if you are offering help, you must be polite in offering help also. Somebody is in need. Hey, do you want help? Don't say like that. Though you are offering help, your tone, your expression must be polite. That's why sometimes if you offer your help impolitely, they may refuse. They may reject your offer. So politeness is very important. Okay, we are ready to help. We are ready to use politeness in our voice and in our sentences. Then how? How to make our request polite? Yes, the main word here is please. Please basically indicates that one is asking a favor from someone to do something. Often a command can also could be expressed in the form of a request, so that it is not refused. Okay, next, pre-activity. Before going to do full activity, pre-activity, starting activity, simple thing. You want to borrow a pen from your friend. How do you ask politely? Definitely, I feel, will you please give me your pen for a while? Could you please give me your pen for some time? There are so many expressions out there. These two are not the final right answers. So you can use any kind of. Next thing is question number two. You want your friend to shut that window. How do you ask? In a polite manner. Polite manner is very important. Then, would you mind to shut the window, please? Could you please shut the window, please? Will you please shut the window, please? If you don't mind, will you please shut the window, please? There are so many expressions out there. Okay. Some modal answers. Okay. Next, activity one. So in your FAIR notebook, not only activity, pre-activity must be written. The questions in your examination, the questions will come from pre-activity also sometimes. Okay, now come to activity one. Read the following conversation and identify the sentences containing a request. Yeah, it is a task. You have to identify the request sentences. The sentence must be in the tone of a request. How do you identify? Very simple, I just told you. Yeah, here is a conversation. Conversation means nothing but discussion, dialogues between two persons or among some persons. Okay. Ravi and Ramesh are there. First, Ravi. I'm going to Hyderabad tomorrow. Ramesh, why? Ravi, I have some important work at the secretariat. I think you all know secretariat. Okay, right. Ramesh, I have a friend of mine working there. Will you please give him this bag? Ravi, that's not a problem. Could you please tell him about my work? Ramesh, I will talk to him today. He will definitely help you. He is the DAS section officer in the Department of Technical Education. Ravi, thank you. Ramesh, welcome. Now, okay, finished. Now, can you identify? Here two expressions are there, two sentences. Can I do? Will you please give him this bag? Could you please tell him about my work? These are polite requests. Okay. Next. Yeah, answers. So I just, in the beginning, I said, this lesson has two parts. So both are related to help only. In the first part, you take help. In the second part, you offer help. You give help. You help them, others. Okay. So request for help, offering help. Request for help, first part. Activity two, it is very, very important. This makes you learn, this makes you practice how to request help from others. If you practice thoroughly, if you practice this table, definitely you will be a master in requests. If you skip it casually, you will not be master. So very important. So how to practice it? I will explain. Here, 1, 2, 3, 4. Four columns are there. First column, could, would, can, will. Four words are there. In the second column, you is there. Third, please. Fourth, the concerned, reason, problem. What is, whatever it is. The content. So you can use any one of the four. Could, or would, or can, or will. And here is only one. You have to club them. You have to mix or club from each column, one. So one example. Could I take, could. Okay. Could you please speak slowly? Okay. Or could you please repeat the lesson? Or could you please help me to reach railway station? Or could you please accompany me to hospital? Or could you please give me the menu? Or could you please lend me some money? In that way. Or you can do in another way. You can use second one. You would. You can begin the sentence with would also. Would you please lend me some money? Or would you please accompany me to the hospital? Or would you please switch off television? Would you please speak slowly? So in that way, this is a drill practice session. So practice thoroughly. You have to write this table in your FAIR notebook. After that, you have to write in this manner. Could you please lend me some money? Would you please accompany me to hospital? Like that. You have to write answers. This is a practice session, drill. Okay. Next, additional information. Some more information related to a request. Asking help. How to ask help? Here some more information is given. The following are the expressions used to request someone to take you to hospital. So start from less polite to more polite. Okay. Here, first one. Take me to hospital. There is no politeness. Please take me to hospital. Okay, somewhat politeness. Will you please take me to hospital? More polite. Can you please take me to hospital? Yes, one more level up. Could you please take me to hospital? Yes. Do you think it would be possible for you to take me to hospital? Do you think you could please take me to hospital? These are from less politeness to more politeness. So practice them. Take one example, one model example. Just like pen. Give me pen. Please give me your pen. Will you please give me your pen? Can you please give me your pen? Could you please give me your pen? Do you think it would be possible for you to give your pen? Do you think you could please give your pen? In that way, you have to practice it. This is one kind of a drill. Practice makes man perfect. English is a skill subject, not theory subject. Just watching, just reading does not give 100% skill. The skill means you have to practice it. Practice only makes you perfect. Okay, come to next part. Here, one more note is there. Please note that in addition to words and sentences, the way you request and your tone determines the degree of politeness also. Suppose, will you please take me to hospital? Will you please take me to hospital? This is not polite. Though your sentence is in a polite manner, but your voice, your tone is not in a polite manner. So polite, the politeness must be in the sentence as well as your voice, tone. Okay. Next. Activity 3. Make requests in the following situations. In your examination, the question comes like this. You are staying in a hostel. The tap in your bathroom is leaking. Request the plumber to repair it. You know, plumber, the person who repairs water and other drainage related problems, things. Okay. See, you have to request the plumber to repair it. In examinations, the question comes like this. The answer must be in that way. Here I have written, the tap in my bathroom is leaking. Could you please repair it today? So you can write in some other ways also. The tap in my bathroom is leaking. Will you please repair it today? Because we have practiced in the activity 1 also, table. Could, can, will, would, could. Okay, you can use them. Next. Request the traffic constable to show you the way to the railway station. Yes, modal answer I have given. Could you please show me the way to the railway station? You can write like that, or you can write in a different manner also. Okay. Next. You can't go shopping as you are busy. Request your roommate to do it for you. How do you request your roommate to bring some material from the shop? One model, a sentence I will tell. Could you please go for shopping, dear, as I am very busy and I cannot do it. Write it in your notebook. Just try yourself. Everything spoon feeding is not good. Just I have given moral expression. You practice them. Next, request the librarian to help you find the thesaurus. Thesaurus means the book containing synonyms and antonyms. Okay, it's a very important book. Okay, how do you request the librarian in finding the thesaurus? In a library, generally in a big library, thousands of books will be there. You have to identify it, you have to get it. It's very difficult if you don't know the proper method. So how do you ask, request? Modal sentence, can you help me please for finding the thesaurus book? Okay, request the counter clerk to cancel your railway ticket. Would you please cancel my railway ticket? Request your classmate to lend you the physics lab record. Can you please lend me your physics lab record? In that way. Okay. This is not a rocket science. It's not a very difficult subject. This is common subject, casual language, not a difficult language. Okay, next, second part, offering help. Offering means giving. The second part of the lesson deals with offering. You will now learn the expressions used to offer help or suggest something for others. Suggestions also offering, that means help, one kind of help. Suggestions, don't go there, do it now. You can do that. It's very difficult. It is that is very easy. In that way, suggestions are also one kind of help. So these requests and offers usually refer to near future. So they the offers will be in the future form, future tense form. Shall I do it? Shall I do it? I shall do it. Changes into question form. Shall I do it? Future. It indicates the future, near future. Okay. Here also activity 4, table for drilling, practicing. Very, very important this one. If you do not practice this table, you will not able to speak. You will not able to offer help in a proper manner. Though it appears very simple, very easy, but it's important. So here, may, shall, let, would, could. Here, I, us, me, you. Okay, we shall try. Help you, get you a glass of water, complete the task together, do it for you. Like to have a cup of tea? Yes, first one. May I help you? You see everywhere, you listen everywhere this one. In companies, hospitals, everywhere. May I help you? Shall I help you? Okay, shall I help you? But this is wrong. Let I help you. Have you seen anywhere this kind of expression? No, we don't use. This is not common, uncommon. Okay, generally, let me do it for you. Let them go. So see, them, me, these are objective pronouns. Generally after let, we write objective pronouns. I becomes objective pronoun, me. Yes, us, okay, but let us talk together. Let us discuss together. So generally, let you go, it doesn't sound common, okay? But if you think it is a objective pronoun, okay. So may, shall, would, could, all, everything, okay. Except let. Let me go, nannu velani vandi. Let me do it. Nannu cheyani vandi. In that sense. Let them go. Valan velani vandi. In that sense, we use let. Okay? So, may I help you? May I get you a glass of water? Do you want water? May I get you a glass of water? Here, next, complete the task together. Shall we complete the task together? So why I am stressing here is, you should not, I told you just practice them. I told you just connect their sentence phrases and make your sentences. That is not right. The sentence must be in a sensible manner. Without sense, the sentence is waste. So meaningful sentence is important. Shall let us complete the task together? So right, let us Would you please? Would you help? No. Yes, right. Would you help? Would you help? Okay. But would you help you? No, run. Next. Would you do it for you? No, run. So what I am saying here is the sentence must be sensible, meaningful sentence. We have to frame the meaningful sentence. Okay. So do it. So may I help you? Shall I do it for you? Shall I get a glass of water? Let us complete the task together. May I like to have a cup of tea? Could you complete the task? Could you complete the task together? Let us complete the task together. Shall I help you? Would you like to have a cup of tea? Let me do it for you. In that way, make meaningful sentences and practice them. Next, additional information regarding offering help. Offering help is quite common in a conversation. It includes the meaning of suggestion. We offer help in a polite manner. When we find someone in trouble or in need, the following are some ways of offering help to others. Different expressions. May I be of any assistance? Is there anything I can do? I will do it for you. What can I do for you? Do you think I can help you? It's my pleasure to help you. Shall I? So these are some modal expressions regarding offering help. So practice them, by heart them. It is very important. You have to practice. In examination point of view, write one modal expressions. One modal expression regarding offering help. They may ask or they may give some situation. They may give situations and ask you the right proper expression. So see, write in the space provided what you will say to offer help in the following situations. First one, a woman who is traveling by a train wants to buy water bottle at a station where the train doesn't stop for more than a couple of minutes. Couple means two. You observe it. You are in the train also, same compartment. How do you offer help? Excuse me, ma'am. Is there anything I can do it for you? Then the woman, yes, please, can you get me a water bottle? Oh, it's my pleasure to help you. So this is the method, you have to write answer. Next, second one. You are going by car. Your neighbor is waiting for an auto to go to his office. How do you offer help? Then modal answer this is, hi sir, do you think I can help you? Yeah, actually I have to go to office. If you don't have any problem, can I drop you? See, first one, sir, do you think can I help you? Second one is, yeah, actually I have to go office. Then you are offering, if you don't have any problem, can I drop you? It's very important thing. Some people may not ready to get offer from others, may not get help from others. So it's better to take permission, prior permission before offering help. Otherwise they may consider it as a kidnap. Others also think it is a kidnap. So don't do that. Or somebody is having difficulty in some heavy luggage. is not able to move with luggage, then if you without asking prior permission, if you give your support, they may think you are a burglar, you are a thief, you are stealing his property. So don't do that. Okay, next. You see an old man who is trying to board a bus with a lot of luggage. Okay, how do you help? How do you offer your help? Before offering help, you have to take permission. That is the important thing here. Before offering help, before helping others, you have to take prior permission. With their permission only, if they agree to take help, then only you have to help. Okay, see, answer model. May I help you, sir, by carrying your luggage? Shall I? In that way. Next. You find that your friend has difficulty in changing the wheel of your motorcycle. This is your friend. Okay, no problem. Okay? Answer, model answer. Do you think I can help you? So this is the thing. Next, common error spot. Generally, we commit mistakes. Grammar is very important thing in every language, especially students. What kind of mistake generally we do? Especially, particularly, these mistakes are related to this chapter. Okay? Please kindly help me. That is wrong. Why? Please kindly help me. Please kindly, both are same. Both convey the same meaning. You can use either please or kindly, but don't use both in the same sentence. Please help me, right, or kindly help me, right, but please kindly help me is wrong. Okay. Next, can you be able to take me to hospital? See here, can, capacity itself tells about capacity. Able, it tells about capacity. So just in the same manner in the first sentence, both convey the same meaning. So we should not use same words in the same sentence. So either you can say can or could. Okay, could you take me? Could is more polite than can. Can shows one kind of capacity. Can you do it? Are you able to do that? Could means will you. Could means please. Can means can you do it? That means pressure, not polite. It is not polite one way I can say. So could you take me to hospital is right, or are you able to take me to hospital is right. Okay. Tips, how to improve communication skills. Okay, up to now you have learned how to request help. A second one, how to offer help, you learned. After practicing, you will be master. Okay, so use please and thanks while making request. After getting the help, you must say thanks. It's very important. You know only how to get help, but you don't know saying thanks. That is not good manners. If anybody offers you help, you have to say thank you. Or if you ask somebody for help, they refuse to help, then also you can say thank you. Okay, no issue, no problem, thank you. You have to say that is good manners. So use please and thanks while making requests. And second is, begin your request with could in formal situations. Just I told you, can is not polite. Okay, that is a demand. The voice appears like a demand. Capacity. Do you have the capacity to give me your pen? Can you give me your pen means? Do you have the capacity to give the pen? So that is asking, that is a one kind of commanding like that. Okay, better use could instead of can. Okay, next assignment. Match the following. Here in the A part and B part, match, we have to match in the A section. Some requests are there. In the B part, it's offering are there. Okay. Offering means nothing but how response. Can you pass the salt box, please? Can you pass the salt box, please? Yes, the answer is certainly, but there is no salt in it. Okay, no problem. Next, can you give me the menu? Menu means the items are available in a hotel, okay, or in very where whatever the things are there. Yes, today's special is Kashmiri biryani. Next, would you like to have some ice cream? Answer, yes. No thanks, I'm suffering from cold. Next, would you like to have tea or coffee? I prefer coffee. Okay. May I know the time, please? Yes, it is 10:05. Okay, next assignment 2. Fill in the blanks with appropriate words given in brackets. Here, very, very important thing is, we in future tense, helping verbs are 2 in simple future, shall and will. We use shall with the pronouns of first person pronouns, I and we, and remaining take the helping verb will. So whenever you get I, whenever you get we, we have to use shall. Okay, see, dash dash I bring vegetables. So right answer is, shall I bring vegetables? Next, dash, you turn off the fan when you leave the hall. Yes, here the pronoun is you. Will you turn off the fan when you leave the hall? Next, you. Will you show me how to download picture? Next, you. Will you get me a tablet when you go out? Next, I. Shall I press the cloths for you? Next to you. Will you make a cup of tea for me? In that way. Okay, answers are given here. Okay, I hope all of you well understood what is the lesson means. I think I explained all the things. What I expect from you, my expectation from you is, you have to practice the activities, all activities thoroughly, write every activity and assignments in your notebook. We shall meet again in the next class. Until then, practice well, learn well. Thank you.